Hi everyone, I'm going to be turning jelly gel into polygel. I have some Venalisa, very extremely thick builder gels. I bought these in the fall and I hauled them out in November. On the haul video, I told you I bought them for a project that I was doing, and this is the project that I'm going to be doing. You know by now that I love to do experimenting. I always tell you I'm not a chemist, and these are my experience, my thoughts, and my opinions. In the past, I have made some gum gels. When I did it, I took clear gel and I mixed a lot of different pigments like makeup and eyeshadow and all this other stuff to it. Was not a good idea, because when you take cosmetics and mix them with gels, there's a lot of different things in cosmetics. One of those ingredients is mineral oil, and it's not a good idea to be mixing all that stuff into your gel. That could probably cause the shelf life of the gum gel that I made in the past go rubbery. Like I said, I'm not a chemist. I don't know. This is just my thoughts. I have learned from the past to just take a already made cover gel that you can get, whether it's, you know, thick like this or a thinner one, and just mix clear, some clear acrylic to it. It just works out a lot better, and you don't have all those extra things in there that you don't need. Here are the two colors here. This is coral pink and this is natural pink. It is very thick. I knew when I purchased this that it wasn't going to be used for making any kind of nails. I did experiment with it and try to put it on a nail and use alcohol to pat it down. Every time the brush hit the gel, even with alcohol, this is what the gel looked like. Do you see those peaks forming? That's what happened. And the more alcohol I used, the more it just got soupy. It was not good for creating any kind of nail. That's not what I bought it for when I purchased it. I was buying it to make polygel. If anyone has any of the real polygels out there, like Gelish or Madame Glam, you know that when you put a bead of it on the nail, it does not level. It will not level. It will sit there. I got to thinking this would be the perfect gel for making polygel, because look, it does not level at all. See that peak there? It's still there. You'll want to have a clear acrylic that is finely milled. You can find finely milled acrylic in a lot of dip systems. You can still use regular acrylic. It just may be a little bit more grittier. I'm also going to be adding a little bit of the Venalisa clear builder gel. The reason for this is sometimes when you have cover gels that are very opaque, they have problems curing in the lamps because the color is so opaque that the light has a hard time penetrating that. And if I add a little bit of clear to it, it opens it up so that the light can get through it. And I'm not going to make a lot. I don't need it. And now we just start mixing it up. Need to add a little bit more acrylic. It's almost there. Just a little bit more acrylic and I think that's gonna be done. Now, it depends on what kind of consistency of polygel you like to work with. If you like it to be a little bit more soft and less dry, well, add less acrylic. If you like it a little bit more drier to roll it in a ball, then add more acrylic. Looks like a wad of bubble gum. I'm going to be demonstrating on a swatch stick. In the dappin dish is isopropyl alcohol. So nice and soft, not too hard. I really love how this works. Don't get your brush extremely wet with alcohol, because I find that it just makes it really thin and gooey. The surface of it looks a little bit grittier. You can see that. At least we know that we can do something with that very thick jelly gel from Venalisa. And also that you can fix your supposed poly gels from Venalisa. Yep, works really nice. Let's add a little bit more right here. Yeah, I think I really like how it works. It's really nice. Oh, a piece of fuzz on there. Make a little gouge in there. And then we'll fix it. Show you how easy it is to fix. Yep. See that? Fixed it right up. I'm gonna cure this for 1 minute. And my lamp is a dual lamp. Cured this for a minute in my lamp. It's a Sun 4. And yeah, it's cured. And there is a slight tacky layer. We're gonna see how it files. It's not really making a lot of dust, really. Not bad. Now we're gonna test it out in a dual form. I got a size 2 dual form. I wanted to have a form big enough so that you could see it really well. Some people take the cuticle pusher and they slide it down like this. And here we go. Here's the inside. I think that looks pretty good. Just for testing purposes, I want to know if it's shiny on the other side. So I'm going to stick it in the lamp for about 1 minute. Here is the dual form. I actually ended up curing it for 1 minute and 30 seconds. And when I put it in the lamp, I put it in the lamp just like this, because that's how it would go in on your finger. So let's turn it over. And here's what the underside looks like, and it appears to be cured. Listen, it's all cured underneath there. And let's take it off, see if it's shiny. Oh wow, yes, look at that. It's shiny. Oh wow, that is so shiny. And it's all cured. I'm liking it. I filed and top coated this, and it looks fantastic. That's the end of my experiment. This poly gel that I made here is pretty impressive. I can't wait to make a set of nails using it. Don't despair if you have the Venalisa poly gel that's in the tube. You can also use this method and make it into some poly gel that you can actually use. And I put the extra poly gel in this container and dated it 2/16. So I'm gonna keep track and see how long it stores, and I will come back and let you know about that. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you tried making some poly gel, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye.